The next item of business is consideration of business motion 8555 in the name of Joe Fitzpatrick on behalf of the Parliamentary Bureau setting out revisions to the business programme for the week. I'd ask any member who wishes to speak against the motion to press the request to speak button now, and I call on Joe Fitzpatrick to move motion number 8555.
Move, Presiding Officer.
No member is asked to speak against the motion, therefore I now put the question to the Chamber. The question is that motion number 8555 in the name of Joe Fitzpatrick be agreed to. Are we all agreed? The motion is therefore agreed to. The next item of business today is topical questions. Question number one, Rhoda Grant.
To ask the Scottish Government what steps it has taken to tackle alcohol misuse.
Cabinet Secretary Alex Neil.
Sir, our Framework for Action document contains a package of over 40 measures which seek to reduce consumption, support families and communities, encourage more positive attitudes and positive choices, and to improve treatment and support services. Together with minimum unit pricing and other regulatory measures on issues such as irresponsible promotion of alcohol, this wider package will help to create the cultural shift required to change our relationship with alcohol. Considerable progress has been made on implementing key aspects of the alcohol framework, including a record investment in tackling alcohol misuse, over £237 million since 2008, delivery of over 366,000 alcohol brief interventions by NHS Scotland, the establishment of 30 alcohol and drug partnerships, development of an implementation plan to deliver the recommendations of the Quality Alcohol Treatment and Support Report, the commencement of the Alcohol Etc. Scotland Act 2010, and the passing of the Alcohol Minimum Pricing Scotland Act 2012 in May 2012.
Rhoda Grant.
Alcohol is killing around 20 people a week in Scotland, still a higher rate than the rest of England and Wales. Minimum pricing is delayed in the courts, so will the Cabinet Secretary now come forward with a meaningful action to tackle alcohol misuse in Scotland?
Presiding Officer, I think it is a bit rich for anybody from the Labour Party, with their constant opposition to minimum unit pricing, now to demand action, when we have already had a 40-point action plan implemented. And as yesterday's report indicated, measures such as ending multiple unit sales are already having a positive impact in reducing alcohol sales in Scotland.
Rhoda Grant.
Thank you, Presiding Officer. The Cabinet Secretary is aware that minimum unit pricing alone will not tackle Scotland's problem with alcohol. He will be aware that Dr Richard Simpson is leading proposals for an Alcohol, Public Health and Criminal Justice Scotland Bill. Will he now back that bill in principle and bring forward Labour's proposals to take action to tackle this problem now?
Cabinet Secretary.
Sir. Minimum unit pricing is not a single silver bullet. We have never claimed that it was, but it is a prerequisite to breaking the back of the problem of alcohol misuse in Scotland. And I would draw Rhoda Grant's attention to now four reports produced by Professor Tim Stockwell, the global expert on this matter, demonstrating beyond any doubt, let alone any reasonable doubt, that unless we affect the price of alcohol, we cannot absolutely beat this problem in Scotland. That is why minimum unit pricing is so essential and why this government, despite Labour's opposition, was determined to deliver it.
Jimmy.
Thank you, Presiding Officer. Is the Cabinet Secretary aware of any other European Union member states who are set to follow Scotland's example in introducing minimum unit pricing? And could this be because this is a policy which has the support of every health organisation in Scotland and each of the chief medical officers in these islands?
Cabinet Secretary.
Presiding Officer, I can tell the member that the Irish Government and the Estonian Government have now adopted a similar policy on minimum unit pricing to the Scottish Government, and I know there are other governments giving similar consideration to following our example. Can I also say, having spoken to the World Health Organization at a conference in Tallinn, Estonia recently, that we have the wholehearted support of the World Health Organization in pursuing minimum unit pricing. So there is no doubt at all that the almost unanimous view in the health professionals globally, not just in Scotland but increasingly across governments as well as in the health professionals in Europe, that there is no doubt at all that minimum unit pricing is the right policy to pursue our objective of reducing substantially the harm that alcohol abuse does.